हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ देवाशीष एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय चैनल स्टैटिस्टिक्स क्यूरियोसिटी। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सॉल्व सम क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम प्रेस्टिजियस आईआईटी जेएम एग्ज़ाम, मैथमेटिकल स्टैटिस्टिक्स एग्ज़ाम। एंड द क्वेश्चंस आर रिलेटेड टू टाइप वन एरर अल्फ़ा, टाइप टू एरर बीटा एंड पावर फंक्शन। ओके, सो आई हैव ऑल्सो क्रिएटेड द वीडियो अबाउट दीज थ्री कॉन्सेप्ट्स and the video is mentioned in I button. You can watch the video and then come to this video to solve these questions. If you watch that video before these questions, it will be beneficial for you. Otherwise, these are sufficient. Okay, let's start the question solving. First of all, the first question is, consider the problems of testing h naught theta is equals to 0 against h1 theta is equals to 1/2. This is null hypothesis, this is alternative hypothesis. Based on a single observation x from uniform theta comma theta plus 1 population, the power of the test reject h naught if x greater than 2/3 is. Let me tell you something. To solve such these questions, you must have three things. First of all, you must have what the probability distribution is talking about, and the second one, the rejection region, or you can say critical region. So here in this question, x is following uniform theta comma theta plus 1, so the PDF of x will be 1 upon b minus a is the PDF. So 1 upon theta plus 1 minus theta. So this will be 1. And also remember, x lies between a to b. This is a, this is b. So x lies between theta to theta plus 1. This range of x is required to solve the probability. Now, the question is asking about the power of the test. The question is asking about the power of the test. So the power of the test, there is a formula for power. Power is the probability of rejecting H naught when H1 is true. Rejecting H naught when H1 is true. In this region, rejecting H naught. In this region, rejecting H naught, we write the critical region, and the critical region is given as x greater than 2/3. X greater than 2/3. The critical region is the rejection region, in the region in which the H naught is being rejected. It is in general given in the question. Okay, so to reject H naught, the region is x greater than 2/3. Given, yani ki under, h1 is theta is equals to 1/2. Theta is equals to 1/2. And I am again saying, please watch my previous video about these topics. The link is in I button. So it will make you, it will be more easier to understand these concepts for you. Okay. Now, to solve this probability, remember, we just have to use this PDF and write the values of theta as 1/2. Now, the PDF is 1. Okay? Theta se theta, these cancel out. 2/3, 2. Now, look at the upper limit. Upper limit is theta plus 1. So, the 2/3, 2, theta plus 1. 2/3, 2, theta plus 1. Now you have to put theta is equals to 1/2. So it will be 1/2 plus 1. Okay. And PDF is 1 dx. Okay. 1/2 plus 1 will become 3/2. So it will be 2/3 to 3/2 1 dx. As you know, this 1 is x. Turn out to be x after integration. And the limits are 2/3 to 3/2. So after solving, this will be 3/2 minus 2/3. And the answer is 5/6. Okay. This will be the answer. This is easy question. Next question. दिस क्वेश्चन इज़ फ्रॉम 2015 एग्जाम IIT जैम. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम 2015 एग्जाम. द क्वेश्चन इज लेट एक्स बी ए सिंगल ऑब्जर्वेशन फ्रॉम ए पॉपुलेशन हैविंग एन एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विद मीन 1/λ. अब वॉट आई हैव सेड अर्लियर, जस्ट राइट द PDF. एक्स फॉलोज एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. एक्स इज फॉलोइंग एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सो द PDF ऑफ एक्स विल बी, रिमेंबर दिस इज मीन इज 1/λ. सो द मीन इज 1/λ. सो द पैरामीटर मस्ट बी लेमडा. सो लेमडा ई की पावर माइनस लेमडा एक्स, लेमडा ई रेस टू द पावर माइनस लेमडा एक्स. दिस इज द PDF ऑफ एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. नाउ यू हैव टू राइट द रेंज ऑफ एक्स. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द PDF ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड द रेंज ऑफ द रेंडम वेरिएबल यूज इन द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सो यू कैन सॉल्व दीज क्वेश्चंस. नाउ द रेंज ऑफ एक्स इज 0 to ∞, और यू कैन से एक्स ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 0. 0 to ∞, और यू कैन से एक्स ग्रेटर देन इज इक्वल्स टू 0. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू द प्रॉब्लम. द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ टेस्टिंग एच नॉट लेमडा इज इक्वल्स टू 2 अगेंस्ट H1 लेमडा इज इक्वल्स टू 4. दीज आर द ऑल्टरनेटिव एंड नल हाइपोथीसिस फॉर द टेस्ट. द रिजेक्शन रीजन इज नथिंग बट द क्रिटिकल रीजन. द रिजेक्शन रीजन इज एक्स ग्रेटर देन इज इक्वल्स टू 3. एक्स ग्रेटर देन इज इक्वल्स टू 3. दिस इज द क्रिटिकल रीजन गिवेन इन द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू फाइंड अल्फा एंड बीटा. अल्फा इज द प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ टाइप 1 एरर एंड बीटा इज द प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ टाइप 2 एरर. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड द फॉर्मूला फॉर अल्फा. अल्फा इज नथिंग बट प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ रिजेक्टिंग एच नॉट, प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ रिजेक्टिंग एच नॉट व्हेन एच नॉट इज ट्रू. इट इज एन एरर. रिजेक्टिंग एच नॉट व्हेन एच नॉट इज ट्रू. सो द रिजेक्टिंग एच नॉट मीन्स क्रिटिकल रीजन. क्रिटिकल रीजन इज एक्स ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 3. एक्स ग्रेटर देन इज इक्वल्स टू 3. एंड एच नॉट इज ट्रू मीन्स लेमडा इज इक्वल्स टू 2. लेमडा इज इक्वल्स टू 2. So you just have to solve this probability by putting lambda is equals to 2 in the PDF or in the limits. Now lower limit is 3 and upper limit is nothing but infinity. Okay, so you have to just integrate this PDF from 3 to infinity and put the value of lambda, put the values of these two lambdas as 2. So it will turn out to be 2e raised to the power minus 2x dx. Okay, so this will turn out to be, let me write it directly, you can solve it on your own. This will turn out to be e raised to the power minus 6. This is just simple calculation, you can solve it on your own. Next is beta. Beta is probability of type 2 error, and the formula for beta is probability of accepting H naught when H1 is true. So the critical reason is X greater than is equals to 3. Critical reason is the reason in which we reject H naught, and acceptance reason is the reason in which we accept H naught. And acceptance reason is just opposite of critical reason. So X greater than is equals to 3, and the opposite of is it is x less than 3, given H1 is true. So what is the H1? H1 is lambda is equals to 4. So you just have to put the value of lambda as 4 in the PDF and solve the probability as x less than 3. So the upper limit is 3 and the lower limit for exponential distribution is 0. So you have to integrate it from 0 to 3. You have to integrate it from 0 to 3 as 0 is the lower limit and 3 is the upper limit given in the question. 0 to 3, and you have to put lambda is equals to 4 in the PDF. What is the PDF? This is the PDF. So you have to put lambda is equals to 4 here and here. So it will turn out to be 4e raised to the power minus 4x dx. So I am writing the answer directly. You can solve it ऑन योर ओन द आंसर विल टर्न आउट टू बी 1 माइनस ई रेस टू द पावर माइनस 12। ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दिस टू क्वेश्चन आर फ्रॉम 2015, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम 2017 एग्जाम। आई डू नॉट फाउंड एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम 2016 IIT JEE एग्जाम ऑन दीज थ्री टॉपिक्स। If you found one, you can tell me the same about in comment section. Okay. Next, 2017 exam. Question is little bit lengthy. Let's do it. Let x1, x2, x3, x4 be a random sample from normal theta 1, comma sigma square. So simply we must write xi follows normal theta 1, comma sigma square. And there are also yi, y1, y2, y3, y4 be a random sample from normal theta 2 comma sigma square. So I must write yj. Yj is following normal theta 2 comma sigma square. So there are two random variables, random samples. One is x1, x2, x3, x4 and other one is y1, y2, y3, y4. Okay. So x1, x2, x3, x4, x4 being a random sample from normal theta 1 comma sigma square, and y1, y2, y3, y4 being a random sample from normal theta 2 comma sigma square. Next, theta 1 and theta 2 belongs to minus infinity to infinity. This is nothing. Further suppose that the two random samples are independent for testing the null hypothesis. So null hypothesis is h naught theta 1 is equals to theta 2, and the alternative hypothesis is h naught theta 1 greater than theta 2. So we have null and alternative hypothesis h as h naught theta 1 is equals to theta 2 and h1 theta 1 is greater than theta 2. Now suppose that a test psi, you don't have to worry about this, just think about the probability distribution and the critical region and the null and alternative hypothesis, that's it. So what is the critical region? Reject h naught if and only if summation xi greater than summation yi. So what is the critical region? So the critical region is summation xi is greater than summation yi, yeah, summation yj. Reject h naught if and only if summation xi summation is greater than summation yj. So this is the critical region. So you also can write it in other words as summation xi minus summation yj greater than 0. Summation xi minus summation yj greater than 0, both I and j follows from 1 to 4. Okay, these are the critical region. Now, then the power of test. So you have to find power of test at these three values. Theta 1 is equals to 1 plus root 2. We have to just put the values of theta 1, theta 2 and sigma square as these values. Okay, now we have to find power of test. So I have already given the formula for power of test as probability of rejecting h naught given h1 is true. So the power is rejecting h naught when h1 is true. The power is rejecting h naught when h1 is true. The rejecting h naught is the critical region. So it is summation xi minus summation yj greater than 0 under h1. What is h1? Where is h1? h1 is theta 1 greater than theta 2. h1 is theta 1 greater than theta 2. So you just have to write h1. Now, as we do not have the distribution of this term, summation xi minus summation j, so I just write this as equation 1 and solve another thing. Now, as xi follows normal with parameter theta 1 comma sigma square. So x I summation x I, or you can say x 1 plus x 2 plus x 3 plus x 4. This summation x I, and summation y j is y 1 plus y 2 plus y 3 plus y 4. So you can clearly see y j is also following normal distribution. So using the properties of normal distribution, we can clearly see summation xi minus summation yj follows normal. Remember, summation xi, the mean of xi is theta 1 and mean of yj is theta 2. So xi minus yj. So summation xi will be 4 theta 1, theta 1 plus theta 1 plus theta 1 plus theta 1, 4 theta 1. This is 4 theta 2. So summation xi minus summation yj will have a mean as 4 theta 1 minus 4 theta 2, or you can say 4 bracket within bracket theta 1 minus theta 2, comma the variance as 8 sigma square. How this 8 sigma square? The variance of summation xi will be variance of x1 plus variance of x2 plus variance of x3 plus variance of x4. This will turn out to be 4 sigma square, and also summation yj will be turn out to be 4. The variance of this will be 4 sigma square, and the variance of this will be 4 sigma square, and the variance of summation xi minus summation j will be the variance of x minus y will turn out to be variance of x plus variance of y. So it will be 4 sigma square plus 4 sigma square, it will be 8 sigma square. Okay, remember these two samples are independent. As these are independent, so there will be no covariance term, and we can write it as this. Okay, now coming towards equation 1, we have to find the distribution of this. So the distribution of this is turn out to be summation xi minus summation yj turn out to be normal 4 theta 1 minus 4 theta 2 comma 8 sigma square. Now also, you know, a random variable following normal distribution, we can convert it as standard normal distribution. So summation xi minus summation yj, summation xi minus summation yj minus mean of this, which is 4 theta 1 minus theta 2, mean of this which is 4 theta 1 minus theta 2 upon standard deviation of this, which is under root 8 sigma, or you can say 2 root 2 sigma, follows normal 0 1. This is simple statistics. Random variable minus mean of random variable upon standard deviation of random variable follows normal distribution, standard normal distribution, if the random variable follows normal. Okay, now coming towards this equation, so we will convert this random variable into z, or this is sometimes termed as z. Now from equation 1, from 1 we can write probability of summation xi minus summation yj greater than 0 under h1. Okay, this will turn out to be probability of z is greater than minus 4 theta 1 minus theta 2 upon under root 8 sigma, or you can say 2 under root 2 sigma. Okay, given h1 is true. How this line comes out to be true? We just have subtracted its mean from this and divided by standard deviation to make it z. So we get this equation. Now just put the values of theta 1 as 1 plus root 2 given in the question, थीटा टू एज वन गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, थीटा वन थीटा टू एंड सिग्मा स्क्वायर एज फोर, और यू कैन से सिग्मा एज टू. सो वी विल गेट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ जेड ग्रेटर देन, जस्ट पुट दीज वैल्यूज इन दिस, सो यू विल गेट माइनस वन. टू एंड फोर टू कैंसिल आउट ईच अदर, जस्ट कैलकुलेट इट, जस्ट सॉल्व इट एंड यू विल गेट माइनस वन. एंड यू कैन राइट इट एज वन माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ जेड लेस देन इक्वल टू माइनस वन. जेड ग्रेटर देन माइनस वन, वन माइनस जेड लेस देन इक्वल टू माइनस वन. दिस इज नथिंग बट द क्यूमुलेटिव डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फंक्शन एट माइनस वन, क्यूमुलेटिव डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फंक्शन एट माइनस वन. And you can write it as cumulative distribution function at 1, as that is, this is a property. I have also discussed this in my earlier videos, phi x as 1 minus phi minus x. So using this property you can write this. Phi 1 is turned out to be 0.8413. This value is obtained from standard normal table, and you have to remember it if you are opting from this IIT JAM, for this IIT JAM exam you have to remember this value. Next question is, question is from 2018 exam. The question is, let x1 and x2 be a random sample of size 2 from a discrete distribution with probability mass function fx theta. Probability x is equals to x is as theta 1 minus theta, theta if x is equals to 0, 1 minus theta if x is equals to 1, where theta belongs to parameter, theta is a parameter basically, have values 0.2 to 0.4 for testing h naught. What is h naught? H naught is theta is equals to 0.2, H1 is theta is equals to 0.4, and consider a test with the critical region. Critical region is little bit different from other questions. The critical region is C, as X1, X2 has values. If I write it as simple, you can clearly see X1 has value 0.1 and X2 has value 0.1. And X1 plus X2 is less than 2 is a critical region. X1 plus X2 less than 2 is a critical region. Now we have to find alpha and beta. As earlier, alpha is the probability of type 1 error, and beta denotes the power. Okay, sometimes beta is denoted as type 2 error, but in this question the question clearly states that alpha is the type 1 error and beta denotes the power. So we have to find alpha and beta. Solving for alpha, alpha is as type 1 error. The formula is probability of rejecting h naught when h naught is true. So the rejecting h naught is nothing but the critical region, and the critical region is given as x1 plus x2 less than 2. Okay, and h naught is true, so h naught is given as theta is equals to 0.4. theta is equals to 0.4. okay, sorry, h1 is theta is equals to 0.4, h naught is theta is equals to 0.2. theta is equals to 0.2. now remember, understand about the consequences for x1 plus x2 less than 2. What may be the conditions for x1 plus x2 less than 2? As we already have x1 as values 0.1 and x2 as values 0.1, so what must be the cases? The cases 1 plus 0 turn out to be less than 2, 0 plus 1 turn out to be less than 2, and 0 plus 0 also turn out to be less than 2, and 1 plus 1 will become 2, which is equal to 2. So we have just to write the cases in which x1 plus s2 is less than 2. So the cases are x1 is equals to 1, comma, x2 is equals to 0, 1 plus 0 less than 2, given theta is equals to 0.2. Plus another case is x1 is equals to 0 and x2 is equals to 1 with theta is equals to 0.2. And another case is x1 is 0 and x2 is 0 with theta is equals to 0.2. Okay. And there is another fourth case, x1 is equals to 1 and x2 is equals to 1. Now, so as there are only four cases, so we can write the sum of these three as 1 minus probability of x1 is equals to 1, comma, x2 is equals to 1, given theta is equals to 0.2, given theta is equals to 0.2. Now, as x1 and x2 both are IIDs, both are random sample. Random sample means these both are IIDs, both have identically and independent distribution. So we can write this probability as 1 minus probability x is equals to 1, write x1 as x and x2 as x. So it will turn out to be probability x is equals to 1, given theta is equals to 0.2 whole square
for x1 and x2, two random variables written as x, both are IID random variables. Now we have to find this probability.
So this will turn out to be 1 minus x probability x is equals to 1 when theta is equals to 0.2. Now coming towards the question, what is the PDF when x is equals to 1? The PDF is 1 minus theta. For x is equals to 1, the PDF is 1 minus theta. And you also have to put the value of theta as 0.2. So it will turn out to be 1 minus theta, and theta is 0.2. So it will turn out to be 1 minus 0.2 whole square. This 1 minus and this square are the remaining terms in the equation. We just have to solve this. Now this will turn out to be 1 minus, this is 0.8, 0.8 square, 0.64. So this is turn out to be 0.36. This will be 0.36. And similarly we can write beta, the formula for beta is probability of rejecting H0 when H1 is true. And remember, this beta is not type 2 error. This is power function as mentioned in the question. Okay. Now we can similarly solve it. We just have to put theta is, take it, rejecting H0 as x is equals to 1, similar critical reason as in alpha. So the equation will be 1 minus probability x is equals to 1 given H1 is true. Here H0 is true, so theta will turn out to be 0.2. Here H1 is true, so theta will turn out to be 0.4. So I can write it directly as 1 minus 0.4, okay, square. So it will turn out to be 0.36. So it will turn out to be 0.64. And the question is asking about alpha and beta. So alpha is 0.36 and beta is 0.64. This is the answer. Next and last question of the video. This question is also from 2018 year. The question is,
लेट एक्स बी अ रैंडम सैंपल फ्रॉम यूनिफॉर्म थीटा कॉमा थीटा स्क्वायर. सो एक्स फॉलोज यूनिफॉर्म थीटा कॉमा थीटा स्क्वायर. आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो अबाउट यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. इट इज ऑल्सो अबाउट यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. एक्स फॉलोज यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सो द पी डी एफ ऑफ एक्स विल बी 1 अपॉन थीटा स्क्वायर माइनस थीटा. ओके इट इज 1 अपॉन बी माइनस ए. एक्चुअली इफ इट इज ए एंड इट इज बी सो इट इज 1 अपॉन बी माइनस ए एंड एक्स ए टू बी सो एक्स इज थीटा टू थीटा स्क्वायर. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट एच नॉट इज थीटा इज इक्वल टू टू एंड एच वन इज थीटा इज इक्वल टू थ्री and alpha and beta are the size and power of the test as in earlier question. So we just have to find alpha plus beta. Also we have critical reason as reject H naught if and only if x is less than equals to greater than equals to 3.5. So the critical reason is x is greater than equals to 3.5 and what we have to find, we have to find alpha plus beta as alpha is probability of type 1 error and beta is power. So the formula for alpha is probability of rejecting H naught when H naught is true plus formula for beta is probability of rejecting H naught when H1 is true. Beta is power, not type 2 error. Okay, it is given in the question. Next, alpha and beta are the sizes and power. Okay, next, probability of rejecting H naught. Reject H naught means critical reason. So X greater than equals to 3.5. This is the critical reason given H naught is true. What is H naught? H naught is theta is equals to 2 and H1 is theta is equals to 3. So theta is equals to 2 plus probability of X greater than equals to 3.5 reject H naught when H1 is true which is theta is equals to 3. Okay. Next. So we just have to solve these probabilities. Lower limit is 3.5. And upper limit is theta square. So theta in this is 2. So 2 square is 4. And the PDF is 1 upon theta square minus theta. So 1 upon 4 minus 2. So it will turn out to be 1 upon 2 dx plus lower limit 3.5, upper limit theta is equals to 3 square, so 3 square turn out to be 9. Next 1 upon 9 minus 3, so it will turn out to be 1 upon 6 dx. Okay, so I am writing it directly. The answer will be, you have to solve the calculation on your own. The answer will be 7 by 6, which will be 1.167. So this is all for today. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to all your friends and subscribe to my channel and share to all your friends. Thank you for watching.